Hi, and welcome to Children's Worship at University Christian Church in Fort Worth, Texas. I'm Reverend Kera Watts, minister to children and families, and I'm thrilled that you have joined us for this incredibly special day. Today is the day in the life of the church that we say is pretty special, not just here at University Christian Church, but the church universal, churches everywhere. The day is called Pentecost, and it involves these things: different languages.
Merhaban.
Ohe.
Hello.
Ni hao.
Fire. Wind. And happy birthday.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, happy birthday. Happy birthday to you.
Birthday to you.
Any guesses on what today is actually called? Did I hear Pentecost? You're correct. Pentecost is a special day in the church where the gift of the Holy Spirit is given to the disciples and those that followed Jesus. This all happened after Jesus died, lived again, and went to heaven. Jesus promised, "Don't be afraid. I will never leave you alone. A helper is coming to show you the way, to stand by you, to comfort you, to be with you always. Just wait." And now on Pentecost, we don't have to wait any longer. Let's watch this story from the book of Acts, A-C-T-S, that tells us the actions of the new Christians and see how all of these things fit together.
Stories of the Bible. God sends the Holy Spirit. These are the apostles.
Hello.
They followed Jesus during his time on earth. Before Jesus went to heaven, he told them to stay in Jerusalem until God sent the gift he promised.
See ya.
So after Jesus went to heaven, the apostles stayed in Jerusalem along with the other people who believed in Jesus. One day, they were all gathered together when there was a sound from heaven like a mighty windstorm.
Wow!
Then what looked like flames appeared and settled on each of them, and everyone was filled with the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit gave them the ability to speak in other languages, and so they started speaking. At that time, there were devout Jews from every nation living in Jerusalem. When they heard the loud noise, they came running to see what it was.
What's going on?
When they saw the believers speaking in their own languages, they were shocked and amazed.
Hey, do you hear this?
They wondered, how can this be? These people are from Galilee, and yet we hear them speaking in our own native languages about the wonderful things God has done. What can this mean?
Whatever.
But others in the crowd didn't believe that it was really a miracle and thought the believers were just acting oddly. Then Peter stepped forward and shouted to the crowd.
Hey, all you!
Listen carefully, all you! He told them that they were not acting strangely, but that this was from God. He reminded them that God said this would happen long ago. Then Peter told them about how Jesus was crucified, but then raised to life again, just as God had said he would be. He told them that Jesus was now in heaven and that God had given the Holy Spirit to them as he had promised. Peter's words changed what the people thought and felt, and they asked, "Brothers, what should we do?" Peter told them, "Each of you must repent of your sins and turn to God and be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ for the forgiveness of your sins. Then you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit."
Wow!
Peter continued to preach to the crowd for a long time, and those who believed what Peter said were baptized. 3,000 people were baptized and added to the church that day. Then all the believers listened to the apostles' teaching and practiced what they taught.
Hey!
They met together in fellowship, shared meals, and prayed together. They were amazed as the apostles performed many miraculous signs and wonders. All the believers met together in one place and shared everything they had.
Here you go. Take this.
Ah, thank you.
They help those in need.
Here, this is for you.
Thank you.
Worshiped together at the temple every day, met in homes for the Lord's Supper, and shared their meals with great joy, all while praising God and enjoying each other. And each day, God added to their fellowship those who were being saved.
The people were filled with the Spirit. Let's join some kids and sing When the Spirit Says Sing. Many things happened on one day, the day of Pentecost. The wind blew through, the fire appeared above the believers' heads, and everyone heard the language that they knew, and they understood the words of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit was given to everyone that day that believed and had hope in Jesus. The Pentecost story is a big story. Let's let some friends help explain it.
So this is where we are in the story.
God made a perfect world.
People messed it up,
but God had a plan to rescue them.
He sent his son, Jesus,
to save everybody.
So we could be with him.
And to save us, Jesus had to beat death.
After he did that, he went to heaven.
But first he told his friends,
the disciples,
to wait.
Because he was going to send them a gift,
the Holy Spirit.
So they waited.
Even when there was a giant party going on outside,
which was called Pentecost,
with people from all over the world.
The disciples stayed together
inside,
waiting.
Suddenly, there was a loud noise,
like a really strong wind.
It must have been pretty loud,
because lots of people came to see what was going on.
Whoosh! Then fire came down from heaven
and landed on top of people's heads.
This wasn't like the fire we're used to.
It didn't burn them.
This fire was way cooler.
See what we did there?
The disciples started speaking different languages.
Languages they didn't even know.
Or hadn't until then.
They spoke Greek,
Hebrew,
Arabic,
all sorts of languages.
It was a miracle.
A lot of people were amazed.
Some were a little confused.
And some didn't know what to think.
But the disciples knew it was a special day.
A guy named Peter spoke up.
He reminded the crowd of who Jesus was.
And God's rescue plan for them.
And lots of people believed.
Anyone who believes in Jesus has the Holy Spirit.
I believe.
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 God had given them the Holy Spirit.
And we can have the Holy Spirit too.
But that's not the end of the story.
We can have the Holy Spirit too, but that's not the end of the story. Because what we do and how we understand how the Holy Spirit works is important. But understanding the Holy Spirit is complicated. Let's check in with our world friends and see what they thought about the story of Pentecost.
Check out my drawing of the disciples.
Oh, careful! They've got fire really close to them.
Yeah, I drew it there. It's the fiery tongues that show up in their story.
That's pretty good, Adeline. But check this out.
House tornado!
An emotional response for my artwork. Just what I was hoping to inspire. Thank you, Clarabella.
Clara, it's all right. These are the things that happened in the Pentecost story when the Holy Spirit showed up. What did you do for your picture?
I drew the disciples a couple of days after all the scary stuff happened on Pentecost, and they've come to terms with being able to speak all languages. That's Matthias eating a sandwich.
Wow, Clara, I was under the impression that we were supposed to show the disciples being filled with the Holy Spirit, not cold cut sandwiches.
I did draw them filled with the Holy Spirit, and it's a grilled cheese sandwich.
Then, where's the Holy Spirit?
It's inside of them.
Yeah, but you see how in our pictures, they have fire and powerful winds rushing all around them. Your picture doesn't have any of that.
No, I just wanted to draw what it looked like when the Holy Spirit fills me, and it usually looks like this.
Fills you? What do you mean, Clara?
Yeah, you can't speak all languages or heal the sick like the disciples did, and I've never once seen you cast out an unclean spirit.
No, I guess not. Oh, but when I was too scared to go on stage for the talent show last winter, I hid in the costume rack and wasn't going to come out until it was all over. But when I got pushed out on stage, people thought hiding was my special talent. And I just felt inside like, Clara, you can totally do this. And then I did.
I have no memory of that.
I remember. So you think that was the Holy Spirit, Clara?
I think so. Pastor Donna says that the Holy Spirit inspires us, and I was pretty inspired.
So, it's kind of like the time I was sick with the gerbil flu. Monty made me a greeting card that had everyone saying how much they missed me.
Ada, this is one of those cards where you can record your voice.
Ada? Ada, should I come out of this coat or not? I need your advice.
Ada, come back. There's no balance to my tricks without you.
You were sick? I don't remember that. Where was I?
I felt so moved and loved by you all that I started feeling better. Do you think that could have been the Holy Spirit, too?
I think it might be.
But none of that stuff sounds as amazing as fire that doesn't burn you or a tornado in your house.
No, it doesn't sound amazing, but it really felt amazing.
But those things could happen anytime. To anyone.
You're right, Victor. Anyone can be filled with the Holy Spirit.
Yeah, Victor, good point. You really get this Holy Spirit stuff.
When we are filled with the Holy Spirit looks like us. When we're smiling, happy, calm, being exactly who we are created to be by God, and sharing God's love and hope in the world. Being filled with the Holy Spirit is that feeling of comfort you feel in your body. And the Holy Spirit is working and moving in us when we feel in our bodies and minds that we need to do something, to say something, to take care of someone. The Holy Spirit is the calm and comfort we feel in our bodies when we know that we are loved. And the Holy Spirit is working in us and around us when we work in the world to share God's love with our neighbor. Now, with all this talk about being filled with the Holy Spirit, it's okay to wonder if you really are filled with the Holy Spirit. One way to recognize the Holy Spirit in you is by paying attention to the special talents that only you have. God gave you those talents because they can be used to share God's love in the world. This week, as a spiritual practice, I invite you to explore the talents God gave you and think about ways you can use your talents to serve others and share God's love. Remember, the important part of a spiritual practice is the intentional part of praying about and talking about what you're thinking and feeling. So don't forget to tell someone about how you are sharing God's love in the world and how it feels. When we talk about God and ask questions, we grow in faith. Every day we join in the work that the Holy Spirit is already doing, and we get to help spread hope in the world. The story of Pentecost reminds us that we are all special because of God's gift of the Holy Spirit to everyone who has hope in Jesus. Now, there was one thing we haven't talked about. Why is the Happy Birthday song a part of Pentecost? Pentecost is the day the Christian church began. all churches who spread the good news of Jesus were born on Pentecost, because from that day forward, the disciples and people like Paul that we've been talking about over the last couple of weeks were filled with the Holy Spirit and started sharing the message of God's love and the hope we find in Jesus. We are filled with the Spirit and part of the same story. So be sure to sing Happy Birthday today and join with your family tonight between 4 and 6 p.m. outside, where we will explore Pentecost and the gift of the Holy Spirit with fire, wind, and serving others. Let's pray. God, thank you for sending the Holy Spirit at Pentecost so that all people can learn about Jesus. Help us to tell the story to others too. Amen.